give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day for what is and what was. Take hold of your iman, don't give in to shaitan. Oh, you who believe, please give thanks to Allah.
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله Our beloved master صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم has said that a person who sends 50 times daily durood or salutations upon me, I will shake hands with him on the day of judgment. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam salatam wa salaman alayka ya sayyidi ya rasulallah wa ala alika wa ashabika ya habiballah. Dearest Islamic brothers and the viewers of Madini channel, Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jal, once again we are blessed to be in this beautiful silsila of Madini channel called Islamic Manners. The topic that we are going to discuss today is about entertainment, amusement. Today is the culture of entertainment, and there are so many tools which are invented and manufactured to entertain people and to give them relief in their so-called stressful life. But again, Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jal, we are Muslims and we need to seek guidance from our deen. Many a times when people are too eager towards entertainment, they are drawn into this world of entertainment and they never come out and they never find time for deen or for preparation of akhirah or to give tarbiyah and training to the children or any other social contribution, and they lose the balance because they start enjoying things so much that they become addictive and they completely gone into their lifestyle. Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jal, our deen guides us and we are going to learn few beautiful things regarding this topic. There's a hadith of Mubarakah in Tirmidhi, in Abu Dawood, and in Ibn Majah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, all those things which are used for entertainment for a man are false, mean are rejected. In other words, are not allowed. Except shooting arrows and training horses and to play with one's wife and to be entertained by his wife. Because there is a point, there is a benefit in training horses or in shooting arrows. In those days, but to this time would be different applications. If there's a war and if the enemies of Islam want to destroy the deen of Islam or the Muslim nation or properties, so they must be able to defend. There is a hadith-e-mubarakah in Behki Sharif, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that chess is the gambling of non-Arabs. And Ibn Shahab reported from Hazrat Abu Musa Ash'ari radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He says that no one will play chess except a singer. So from this we learn that things that are made up to keep people busy with certain things and makes them neglectful from the deen and from ibadat and from Almighty Allah Azza wa Jal are dangerous for them, therefore they are called as batil, false, unacceptable. Similar would be the situation of playing cards. As in Urdu we say tash, tash ke patte khelna, playing cards. And a lot of people have habit and they say, no, we're not gambling, we're just passing time. Why can't they pass time by reciting Durood Sharif or by reciting Quran-e-Kareem or by reading a book, something that would benefit them in the dunya and in the hereafter and beautify their akhlaq and character. So this is also the trick of shaitan that he uses on the people. There is a hadith mubarakah in Tirmidhi Sharif, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has prohibited from the fight of animals. Fight of animals means bringing animals and let them fight and then get entertainment by watching that fight of animals. So that is prohibited by our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that two voices are cursed in the dunya and in the hereafter. The one voice is the sound of music at the time of singing something. That's cursed. And the sound of crying at the time of sorrow or calamity. So therefore those who use musical instruments at the time of singing something and those who cry with loud voice at the time of calamity or difficulty, they must learn a lesson from this Hadith Mubarakah. And there is a Hadith Mubarakah in Behki Sharif, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that with singing songs, hypocrisy grows in the heart like with the water crop grows. So you keep on giving water, your crop will keep on growing. And you keep on singing songs or listening songs, your nifaq, your hypocrisy would keep on increasing and growing. So it is up to us, if we have that evil habit, we need to understand and put stop to it, because there is no such thing as entertainment by listening these evils, because these things are leading you towards the path of Jahannam. There's a Hadith Mubarakah in Tabarani Sharif. Hazrat Ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited from singing the song and from listening the songs, and from backbiting, and from listening the backbiting, and slandering, and from listening slandering or spying. So in this hadith of Mubarakah, we learn that to listen to the songs is as bad as singing the songs, and to listen to ghibat is as bad as making a ghibat, and to give hearing to slandering is as bad as slandering itself. So therefore we must be very careful when someone comes and starts making ghibat of someone, or wants to sing a song, or wants to entertain you, or want to tell you stories of others, and spying upon someone. We must be bold enough and brave enough to say, sorry, I cannot hear this. So that way we can save ourselves. But it is very unfortunate that not many of those people are left these days who have this courage to put a stop to it. There are people that are seen and noticed in public gatherings and weddings who are inspired by the mahawal of Dawat Islami, that when a song started in a wedding hall, they put their fingers in their ears and left immediately in front of everyone. This should not have been done by only few people. This should have been done by every Muslim male and female who is there. But unfortunately, people can't do that. They don't find the courage. Even if they think and believe that this is what is happening is wrong and it's unacceptable, but nobody will take initiative to show that we are unhappy or we dislike what is happening. There's a hadith of Mubarakah in Bahki Sharif. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, Allah Azza wa Jal has made wine, any other liquor, gambling, and drum haram. Drum, that people beat drum as a part of music instruments. So it has been mentioned together with liquor and gambling. So those who love tabla, love dhol or drum, they must learn a lesson from this hadith of Mubarakah, that it's very dangerous because it has been made haram by the founder of this deen, our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and nobody has the authority to change this law. Everybody has to obey and follow. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that everything which gives intoxication is also haram, whether it is in the form of liquid or in the form of any solid ingredient, or in the form of powder, or in any form it might be, if it gives intoxication, this is haram. At the time of Eid or in weddings, it is allowed to play with duff. Duff is actually a small size of drum, that it has a skin on one side and does not have skin on the other side. And people play that. So at the time of Eid or wedding, the duff is allowed, providing that those are plain, simple duff. It doesn't have those rings around it which produce musical noise or enhance that beating of drum. That is not allowed. And these days, the most of the duffs which are used have those rings around it. And it must not be played on the principles of music. It must be odd, and that must be in disorder. There must not be an order in it. There must not be a sequence or following a principle of music or rhythm in it. That's also the condition. That type of beating of duff is allowed for these occasions. For example, if it's a Eid, if it's a wedding, not for other occasions as well. And in the month of Ramadan, at many places people beat Naqara. Naqara is also a kind of drum. It has skin on one side, and its shape is like if you cut the coconut into half. So that would be the shape of Naqara. And in many masajid, they beat at the time of iftar or sahri in order to inform people that the sahri has ended or people can open their fast. This is allowed because in this situation, this beating of drum is not used for entertainment purpose. So the principle must be kept in mind that whenever something is used for entertainment purpose, then it would be prohibited except those entertainments which are sanctioned and allowed by our deen. It is najais or haram to dance and to clap. Like when people sing, they clap with their hands. And to play guitar, harmonium, drums, tabla, those type of instruments. And all other types of tools of musiqi and music are najais. People should refrain from them, refrain from playing, and refrain from listening, because this could be very dangerous for a Muslim to be continuing in this type of things and still believe that he's doing right. Or maybe sometimes people feel, well, we have been doing it from ages. Oh, well, so and so person that in their understanding they think is a learned person, is a great person. He was doing this, or he was at this place where such things were happening and he did not stop it. So therefore it is. So people have different way of thinking and looking at things, and they have different standards of greatness. You know, who is really great, who is really salih, who is really muttaqi, who really fears Allah Azza wa Jal, who is really knowledgeable of the laws and who practices the laws. So people are unaware of those qualities of men of Almighty Allah Azza wa Jal. Therefore, whoever they think is a great in their eyes, they follow. So my advice is that we should take from Quran Pak, from a hadith of the beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and from the sayings and the research of jurist imams and the celebrated and authentic scholars of Islam, and practice upon it, then inshallah Azza wa Jal, we will be on the straight path and on the right path, and we'll be sure and certain that what we are doing is 100% correct. and nobody can point finger at us, and we'll be fully satisfied that what we have done not for entertainment, but for the pleasure of Almighty Allah Azza wa Jalla. We also learn a beautiful masala that it is najais and it's haram to bring animals to fight for the entertainment purpose. Like people have fight of roosters or rams or some places maybe bulls. They have different places, different things that they use them for fight, and then sometimes they even gamble while the animals fight. So just the mere fight of animals is haram, and to participate in such event and be entertained by such event is also najayiz and haram. If one wrestles not for the purpose of entertainment or amusement, but for the fitness of the body, that is allowed. So the intention is that if I keep my body fit, if I wrestle, then if there is a need in the battlefield with the enemies, then I will be fit to do the job properly. I will not get tired, I'll have more power and quickness and fitness in my body, so I can do my job very well. So if that is the intention, and this is jaiz, and it's very much liked in Sharia, and one would earn the sawab. Providing that the sitr is covered. Sitr of man is from under navel till under knees. So this area can never be exposed. If one exposes this area, he is committing an act of haram, and that's a major sin. So it is not even allowed to see and look at someone who's wearing short pants, where half the thighs are open and half are covered. Or maybe wrestlers who are wearing a small piece of clothes, brief type. So that is not allowed. So the wrestling is allowed for the purpose of fitness, providing that the sitr is covered properly. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam also wrestled or had kushti, in Urdu we call it, with Rukana, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam defeated him 3 times. And Rukana was a professional wrestler. And why Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam engaged in wrestling with him? Because this was the request of Rukana, that if you defeat me in fight, I'll become Muslim. And when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam defeated him 3 times, he became Muslim. Alhamdulillah. And when a person uses words of humor, and there is no indication or word of shamelessness or indecency, there's no vulgar language, there's no izai Muslim, there's no words which hurt other individuals or Muslims, just to make someone happy, this is allowed. There's no problem with that. But if there are a lot of these days comedians who are trained to make people laugh, and a lot of people have tendency to go and listen to such comedians. And they are totally ignorant of rules of Islam. And so commonly they use the words of blasphemy, kufr, and people are enjoying and laughing. So to go at such places to entertain yourself, to laugh, you might end up losing your iman and come back empty, and you would not even know that you have lost your iman. It's very dangerous. So dearest Islamic brothers and the viewers of Madani channel, as I said in the beginning, that today is the age of entertainment. And accessibility is so affordable and common that you can have all your TV programs and movies and games on your mobile, on your cell phone. So the deen is there to guide us how to manage this advancement. Should we just go with the flow and do not worry about the akhirah? Or should we sit and ponder for a while and say, wait a minute, I'm different compared to others. I'm a Muslim. I've been sent here with set of rules. I have a proper, manageable, practical constitution for my life. And let me look into my constitution and see what my constitution says in order to behave in this environment of entertainment. And unfortunately, most of the people have lost the balance. And there are so many wrongs that are happening on the name of entertainment are not being seen as wrong anymore, are acceptable. In olden days, the children, the daughters, the boys were not able to sit with parents, especially with the father, to watch films and movies and dramas. But today, they do it together as a family. And it's no more taken as something evil or bad. It's something accepted. So TV is the entertainer of every home today. So whatever you want to watch, it's there, it's available. And the elders of the family are not even at home most of the time. So we give that tool to our children and we give them remote controls, and at a young age they know very well how to change channels. They know how to remove the age restriction codes and they can watch so many evils and which are very dangerous for the akhlaq. Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jal, in this critical time of entertainment, when TV became inseparable from the homes of Muslims, Dawat Islami planned and thought something, that we cannot remove TV from their homes. We tried, but we failed. So let's give them something on the very same TV where so many evils are being displayed, so many attacks on Islam, so many destroyer of Muslim character programs are being played. So let's give them something which will reaffirm their faith, their iman, the akhlaq, the character. So alhamdulillah, we got Madani channel today. A Madani channel is a channel which is totally, completely Sharia compliant. Because on the TV screen, you can only see what you are allowed to see in the real life. And what you are not allowed to see in the real life, you cannot see on the screen of television. So alhamdulillah, all the silsilas and programs that take place on Madani channel are such which you are allowed to see in real life. Therefore, the vast majority of ulama-i-kiram, without doubt, have sanctioned and gave their statements openly that they are endorsing Madani channel, and they have requested the Muslim community to watch Madani channel and support Madani channel. So alhamdulillah azza wa jal, in this beautiful environment of Dawat Islami, we are gaining so much. Dawat Islami is striving to fulfill the needs of the Muslims and reviving so many beautiful matters of our deen. So wherever we might be, join Dawat Islami, attend weekly ijtimaz of Dawat Islami, travel in Madani Qafilas, fill in the Madani In'amat, which is a very well prepared program of self-accountability and reckoning. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to practice upon what we have learned, and give us the goodness of this dunya and the hereafter. Ameen. Bijahin Nabil Ameen. Sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam.
Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day for what is and what was. Take hold of your iman. Don't give in to shaitan. Oh, you who believe, please give thanks to